Hey, my name is Lucas, and I'm a CPO with Ottobock, and this is O&P Workshop Insights. Today, we're going to be talking about how to successfully install the Ottobock 21Y14 push valve. Here, I'm going to show you the steps of installing the dummy, as well as drilling a hole for proper vacuum forming. The first step is to first identify where you want to put the dummy. For an above knee model, we generally want to aim for distal medial area of the residual limb. So I will take my round dummy here, and I have an X already drawn to mark the general area, but now I will take the dummy and I'm going to trace it and draw a circle. Now that I have my circle here, I need to take my flat RAS and ensure that I get a nice even flat surface so that this sits flush up against the positive mold. So I'm gonna lightly shave. It does not take much effort to get a nice flat surface. The process that I'm doing here would be exactly the same if you were using a plaster model. We're using a foam model today. It's crucial that you take your time during this step to ensure you do not have a leak in the finished test socket that we're gonna be fabricating. Again, just short, easy strokes with it. That is looking great. So the next step here is we're gonna go ahead and retrace it so we know exactly where it is. This is one of my favorite tips. So our next step is we're going to take a long drill bit and drill a hole all the way from the bottom through the top. What this is going to do, it's going to create a chamber for vacuum to pull around the dummy when we're making our test socket to ensure there are no leaks on the valve. I'm gonna mark my center point here where the dummy will be attached with just a little mark, okay? As you can see there, we have our hole. The reason I do that is because I wanna ensure when I drill up into the positive model here, I do not wanna go through this hole as it's the attachment point for the dummy. So I'm gonna drill my hole above here, above the attachment point of the dummy. And it's important that you get the correct angle to go through the top of the mold. Again, you can do the same thing with a plaster model. We're using foam today. After you drill the hole through the entire length of the positive model, it's important that you blow air to clear it out. Now that we have our hole drilled here for a channel of vacuum when we make the test socket, it's now time to attach the dummy. We have our marking earlier where we're gonna attach the dummy with the screw, put it right there. It matches our outline. And then I'm just going to screw it in. As you can see, our dummy is nice and flush against the mold and we're ready to pull our test socket. As you can see here, we have our vacuum that is pulling underneath the mold. And because we drilled the hole where the dummy is earlier, it is pulling in nice and tight around the valve so we have no leaks in the finished product. What I'm doing here is I'm flattening the plastic even on all sides to ensure there's no leak in the valve. The valve will sit flush up against the test socket. Here we have our finished check socket with the Ottobock push valve. Since we took the time to drill a hole through our positive mold earlier in the video, as well as flattening out the area where the dummy was, we now have a valve with no leak. In order to ensure there's no leak in the valve, you want to make sure you fill the socket with water and then take an air compressor, blow some air around the valve and ensure there are no bubbles, no leaks, ready to be fit. Be sure to check out our YouTube channel at Ottobock Professionals and leave a comment or question below.